Alright, okay, today for our project we'll be examining INFX. This firm, it's a very popular retail foreign exchange trading firm, and but we'll be examining a situation in China, and there's been rumors that it might be a scam firm. When we choose this situation, it's because that it's a very well-known situation in China, and there are many players in this INFX in relation to this INFX, and they have many strategies to try and maximize their payoff. However, there is a high percentage they might lose money, and in exchange for that, they might get huge returns. Alright, let's move on to the next one. However, there is a silver lining. There is a chance if you do know how to arbitrage in another company that you can actually have a definite 100% profit in it, in the sense that you invest some in INFX and some in another company, and that if INFX doesn't do well, you still have the other company to back up on. So how that's how you make profit. But this this silver lining of making profit is not well known. In the game that my friend would be explaining afterwards, there will be two players, and that one of them would be these agents hired by INFX to trick people into investing, but they have the choice. Their strategy is to decide whether they want to teach people how to arbitrage or not. And the other player in this game is the firm itself, INFX, and they are deciding, or their strategy is to decide whether they want to pay extra commission to you.
The game one is a simultaneous game. In this game, there is an interest conflict between the agent firm and the INFX firm. Since the agent firm pays agent firm gets the commission from the ARX firm by teaching customer to how to earn more money, therefore attract a lot of investors in the market. So, however, the ARX will bear the huge loss since the agent firm will make a lot of arbitrage. So arbitrage will explore the profit from the firm. For this payoff, the agent firm choose to teach, and the INFX choose to pay the commission fee, which means the INFX will get the highest commission fee if the INFX willing to pay. However, the INFX will bear the huge loss since the arbitrage opportunity. And for this one, the agent firm choose to teach and get more commission fee. And for INFX choose to don't to pay, since the INFX don't to pay the commission to agent firm, so the agent firm bear some of the loss. However, teaching activity will produce more arbitrage, so the INFX firm will bear this amount of loss, but it will less than before since they don't pay the money to agent firm. And for this one, the agent firm don't to teach, and the INFX pay the commission fee to the firm. So they both keeping get the profit from the customer, from the normal investor. For this one, the agent firm choose to don't teach, and INFX don't pay the commission. It will reduce the agent firm profit, and because of don't pay, and it will also reduce the customer. So the payoff will be less than before. In this game, the Nash equilibrium is this one, minus 1 and 8. Because the dominant strategy of the agent firm is to teach, and however, there is no dominant strategy for ARFX. The game 2 also is a simultaneous game. In this game, there are two arbitrageurs who want to get the extra profit from the funding pool. There is an interest conflict between those two arbitrageurs. If they both invest too huge, and it will need to get this profit because it will attract other arbitrage into the market. And if one invests a huge sum, one invests less, and who invests a lot will get a higher profit, and the other will get the lowest profit. Since there are no arbitrage into the market, so the profit will be 10. It's highest profit. And if both of them invest less, which means they will no arbitrage into the market, so it will increase the payoff to 6-6. And the dominant strategy for both arbitrage is to invest a huge sum. So this is the Nash equilibrium for this game.
Alright, in this game, the third game, it is a sequential move game, and it is after the arbitrageurs, the people who know how to make use and take advantage of the exchange market to make a profit. After they invested make use of this opportunity and make the firm, the INFX, lose lots of money, while they gain money instead. So over here in this game, we have two players, the managers and the owners. The managers, their strategy is to whether to lie or to not lie. But what are they lying about? They are lying about the financial report of the company because people know how to expose, people know how to exploit this arbitrage, and turns out that the company is actually making loss or not. So yes, they're deciding whether to tell the truth of the financial report or tell the lie. And as for the owners, their strategy is to start a Ponzi scheme or not, is to try and salvage their loss, try and cut their losses. So their choices is to either start this cheating scheme or don't start this cheating scheme. As I said before, it is a sequential move game. So in this case, the managers get to start first, and there's this informational constraint here. So the owners don't know what the managers decide at that point of time. So in this case, the managers, they got an incentive to lie over here, as seen over here. They get a higher payoff. That's why their dominant strategy is to just lie. And this after that, the owners would find out that they have lied. They are left with the choice of whether to start a Ponzi scheme, which would get a payoff of 3, or don't start, which will get a payoff of negative 10. So of course, they would start a Ponzi scheme and try to cut their losses of the company. Okay, in conclusion, this actually happened in real life. And yes, according to these dominant strategies and all what happened, as we explained over here. And yes, there is a chance that it might happen in the future again, because everything is under legal boundaries. They are not being caught or being punished trying to make people lose money. And yes, it ends up with many losses, people losing lots of money for many people. And with the existence of these players and the greed and these games, the INFX doesn't stand to make much profit, or even they might have some losses in the company. But however, they are forced to continue to try and salvage their losses.